We're kicking off a new Politico series, All Policy is Local, and we're starting with energy, which is playing an important role in this year's midterm election, and nowhere more so than Colorado and Senator Udall's seat.
That's right.
Tell us,
I mean,
why Colorado?
It's sort of, Colorado right now is sort of the intersection of two of the biggest energy issues that are out there right now. Oil and gas drilling and fracking in particular, and Keystone, the Keystone Pipeline. The pipeline doesn't go through Colorado, but you might think it does because there's so much discussion about it there. So I went up to Colorado for a few days and went to sort of oil and gas country and talked to some people there and talked to both Udall and his challenger, Cory Gardner. And they're sort of, in a lot of ways, they're on the same page on these issues, but Cory Gardner is painting himself sort of as like Mr. Fracking, you know, and it's a very sort of drill baby drill mentality. And Mark Udall sort of has a more nuanced approach, and he's getting some criticism from the right for that.
Can you talk a little bit about how Udall is stuck between constituencies here? I mean, there's a very strong environmental activist element in Colorado, but this industry is creating a lot of jobs there, as you report, and he's sort of pulled between his local economic needs and also where the more liberal base is on this
exactly
issue.
I mean, he has a reputation in Colorado for being a conservationist and a sort of green-minded environmentalist, but at the same time he can't sort of deny or ignore the reality on the ground there, which is that fracking is huge. I mean, it's everywhere. I mean, there's this one county in Colorado, for example, that there's a well for every dozen people. That's a lot. I mean, it's more than I've ever seen anywhere. And he, so he's having to, and to some extent needs to, embrace drilling in some capacity. Now, he is very concerned about the safety issues, and he talks about that a lot, too.
But really has avoided taking a firm stance on this or on the Keystone Pipeline.
Yeah, I mean, on Keystone, he hasn't made a decision on what he thinks the merits of the project are. He says we need to wait to see what the analysis says. On fracking, I mean, he has embraced fracking to an extent, but always with a mind toward balancing it out with other forms of energy and ensuring that that there's, you know, safe regulations imposed.
And the Udall family name there really signifies conservation. It really stands for something there. Tell me about that tension, the push and pull between the jobs and the conservation.
Sure.
Aspect.
I mean, there's a couple things. I mean, his wife is the former head of Al Gore's climate change group. So, I mean, you have to wonder what the conversations at home are, you know, when he's talking about fracking. And his family, you know, it's a legacy family in the West, and they've been around for decades, and conservation, just by nature of being Colorado, is a huge issue there. And his family has sort of been a steward of the environment for a long time.
What was the biggest surprise for you when you were out there?
I think for me, like, going to a place where you drive down the highway and there's an oil rig every 20 feet. You know, it's like really unbelievable. Mm-hmm. And it's,
so it's one visually of the most, striking.
Yeah, one of the most beautiful places I've ever seen, probably. That the Rocky Mountains sort of overshadowing everything. And then you see a drilling rig literally every corner. Mm-hmm.
Are people engaged on this Senate race? I mean, we're obsessed with 2014. We're obsessed with
2016
already.
Yeah, that's right. We've gone past
you're
that.
You're there talking to real voters,
right?
Which is something we like to do on occasion. Are people even connecting on this particular Senate race yet, or not? What did you
find? I think that people really care about the policy issues. Like, people really care about what's going to happen with oil and gas drilling there. But I think people are a lot less focused on the Senate race. I mean, we like to put a lot of attention on it, obviously. But the people that I talked to just really hadn't even considered how this is going to impact, you know, 6-7 months down the road.
From the Washington perspective, though, Gardner's a rising star in the Republican Party on these issues. Tell us a little bit about
why. Oh, yeah. I mean,
why.
He is on the House Energy and Commerce Committee. He proposed a bill that essentially would send more natural gas to Europe as a response to the tension in Ukraine. And House leadership has sort of hotlined that bill, and it's going to come onto the floor pretty soon, kind of give him an opportunity to really step into the spotlight. Yeah, I mean, he talks about energy is essentially his big issue.